Hello, I'm Chef Rakesh Sethi, Corporate Executive Chef for Radisson Hotel Group, South Asia. And in today's module, we intend to study about food safety, food hazards, and food spoilage. Firstly, we'll understand what food safety is and why is it important. As per the Food Safety and Standards Act 2006, food safety refers to assurance that food is acceptable for human consumption according to its intended use. Food safety helps in prevention of foodborne illnesses that may be caused due to improper handling, preparing, or storage of food. To understand food safety in depth, we need to understand what are food hazards. Biological, chemical, or physical agents in food with the potential to cause adverse health effects are called food hazards. Hazards may be introduced into the food supply anytime during harvesting, formulation and processing, packaging and labeling, transportation, storage, preparation, and serving. There are three types of hazards: physical hazards, chemical hazards, and biological hazards. Let's discuss them one by one. Firstly, physical hazards. Hazards caused due to addition of any foreign object that may be added intentionally or unintentionally into the food. For example, broken pieces from crockery, small bones or shell left in the food can lead to choking or internal bleeding. Long and dirty nails, handling food without wearing hairnet and hand gloves during food preparation. Few more examples of the contaminants are any jewelry that the person handling food is wearing, metal pieces from cans and stapler pins, plastic films or foils used for wrapping food items, addition of dust or dirt, pest dropping or fur. Second hazard we are going to study is chemical hazards. Chemical hazards are caused due to any chemicals which may be naturally occurring or process-induced chemical substances that may cause foodborne illness. Factors that may cause chemical hazards include cleansing products and sanitizers, pesticide residues on raw ingredients such as fruits and vegetables, insecticides, rodenticides, colorants, equipment lubricants, chemical food additives and preservatives. Excessive use of chemicals intentionally or unintentionally can cause foodborne illnesses. Thirdly, biological hazards. Biological hazards occur when food gets contaminated by microorganisms found in the air, food, water, soil, animals, and human body. Many organisms are essential for life itself. However, given the right conditions, some microorganisms may cause foodborne illness. Microorganisms associated with this hazard include bacteria, fungi, yeast, or substances that may pose a threat to human health. Biological hazard is a major concern in the food processing as this kind of hazard may cause maximum illness outbreak. Before we move ahead, it is important to know about certain harmful substances in food known as allergens. An allergen is any substance eaten or inhaled which causes allergic reaction due to hypersensitivity of immune system towards it. Nowadays, a lot of people have food allergies. Consumption of certain foods may lead to allergic reactions in human body, which are hazardous and even can cause death. Some common allergenic foods are nuts or peanuts, dairy products, shellfish or mollusks, milk, eggs, sesame seeds, soya, and certain food additives.
it is important to provide allergen information and establish controls at the stage of food handling to ensure food safety and prevent food spoilage.
The next big question is, what is food spoilage? Food spoilage is a process in which food quality, texture, or nutritional value of the food deteriorates and becomes unfit for human consumption. There are 21 major reasons of food spoilage, and each must be controlled while food handling. Foreign matter. Anything that is not considered as food or food substance is considered as foreign matter. For example, human hair, stapler, plastic, metal particles, etc. Lack of proper drainage. Improper drainage system may lead to accumulation of waste product, which in turn can lead to pest and rodent infestation. Use of non-food grade equipment and utensils. Use of non-food grade equipment or container results in decrease of the shelf life and increases the risk of metal contamination of the food article. Improper handling of food. Handling food with unclean hands and wrong selection of equipment and packing material results in food spoilage. Improper processing. Wrong or incorrect method can lead to major changes in the final cooked product. Residues of chemicals. Chemical residues can come in contact at the stage of harvesting, through residues of equipment or utensil sanitation operations. Non-standard sanitation. It is important to carry out strict guidelines while carrying sanitation procedures. For example, if chemicals are used in less or more quantity, then the sanitation procedure will fail. Use of poor raw material. Raw material selection must be based on strict scientific reference and frequent sampling. Additives. Additives of any nature like essence, flavor, etc. can spoil food if not used in right quantity. Non-potable water. Water is involved in food processes. Therefore, use of non-potable water for food operations can lead to foodborne diseases. Water in food industry must conform to IS 3025 and IS 10500 standards. Improper storage. Improper storage can lead to cross-contamination of food material. Right combination of duration, temperature, ventilation, and segregation defines a good storage. Not following FIFO. FIFO is first in, first out. It is the most adopted method of food industry and ensures guests with the delivery of safe food. Illness or injury of staff. Food safety of consumer relies in the hands of food handlers. Thus, persons suffering from any kind of contagious illness such as cold, cough, any open wound, etc. can lead to food contamination. Improper segregation. Segregation of food, especially of vegetarian and non-vegetarian food, is essential to prevent cross-contamination and helps in safeguarding the interests of the guests. Humidity. Humidity results in rapid multiplication of the microorganisms. Temperature. Temperature of cooking, holding, reheating, storing, serving, transportation, each one of this is an important factor in keeping food safe. Time. Display time, holding time, and discard time for already stored items is crucial for food safety. Non-food grade packing. Food should not be packed in unacceptable or low quality packing material. Pests. Food attracts pest infestation. Thus, care must be taken to plan pest control through devices and other forms of controls to restrict pest infestations. Body fluids of rodents or pests. The body fluids such as urine, fecal matter, etc. of rodents or pests can get into the food processes and make food unsafe for consumption. Improper waste disposal. Improper waste disposal can lead to food spoilage or food contamination, as waste produced is the basic breeding ground for flies and other pests and rodents. To summarize, today we have covered what is food safety, factors affecting food safety, that is food hazards, and lastly, food spoilage. All the above factors should be well studied and followed with full diligence, as it leads to overall well-being and hygiene of the consumer and also avoids wastage of food. One should remember, it is always better to be safe than to be sorry. That's all for today. Thank you for watching this video.